championship bout between Sugar Ray Leonard and Roberto Duran. The title fight will be brought to you by Budweiser. For all you do, this Bud's for you. We may have a chance to talk to Burbick if he comes around this side. And we're just waiting to see if he comes around this side. Perhaps we'll have a chance to talk with Trevor Burbick. Well, Trevor Burbick
has gone back to the dressing room. We are having one of those nights where anything happens. Now, take a look at Tate. Tate is absolutely in shock. His aspirations, his hopes, his dreams for the heavyweight championship shattered by an unknown who has come in and completely cleaned John's cage. Now, what do you think about that,
Bill? Bertie, I have to tell you, I am absolutely amazed. It is just one of those shockers. I had been here all week. We'd gotten into a conversation, and then this happens to John Tate.
Well, this crowd has been hushed by the shock of seeing the ex-heavyweight champion John Tate hammered to the canvas by a man who had no chance. He is having a difficult time negotiating the stairs. John Tate has being helped out, and I am beginning to wonder whether John has reached that point where he cannot take a punch, because following Weaver's hammering of John, he could not talk or move for almost half an hour.
Sugar Ray getting ready, getting a nice good sweat, because it's a cool night here. He doesn't want to get caught cold. Ace Miller told Jay Edson, famous referee, I brought him back too soon.
He brought him back too soon? I disagree with that. I think that the opponent had something to do with it. The opponent is extremely good. He was strong. He was aggressive. John fought a cold fight from the very beginning. I don't think you can bring a fighter back too soon from a knockdown like that. It was one of those things that styles occur in boxing. I don't think John's mind was on this fight. I just didn't see that fire. We spoke of the lethargy. We spoke of the lack of fire. You cannot do that when you're facing a good champion.
You know, as we watch Sugar Ray Leonard with his WBC belt, I want to make that point again, because I said it to you at the start of the Tate fight. On a night like this, Bertie, and you're a medical man and you would know, did he seem warmed up enough?
John, at the beginning, wasn't warmed up enough, but he was mentally even less warmed up. He just seemed to be in a little fog the first two or three rounds, as both of us commented and saw. But once he got warmed up, he seemed to be doing all right until the other man took the action. Once the other man took the play away from him and became the aggressor, it looked like John was just fading by the round. And the other guy was getting stronger and stronger. And no credit away from Burbick. Burbick took a lot of punishment, took a lot of shots, and hung in there and kept coming back. Now, you can't take credit away from a guy that's fought a gutty fight like Burbick, but I just wonder what this means to John Tate. Certainly his career is not over, but certainly it takes some strong evaluation. I would not put him in for another 90 days into a gym. Forget a fight. I would not put him into a gym for 90 days. I'd give him a long rest. I did not like the way he looked right in front of us. He lay face down, not being able to hear a count, not being able to move a muscle, not being able to do anything for well over 20 seconds, more than 30 or 45 before they could even pull him in, and he looked very shaky when he went to the corner. I don't like a fighter that looks that knocked out, Bill.
Purdy, I said to you at the beginning of the fight, twice he's been stopped. Once as an amateur, the other time, of course, in the fight with Weaver. And I said, does a guy get gun-shy? For one thing, Burbick's lack of reputation mostly is that he doesn't take a real good punch, but that now, I mean, Bernardo Mercado can hit you and take you out any time. It seemed to me the tape looked gun-shy, and then once he recognized that he wasn't hurting this guy, it bothered him terribly.
Yeah, I think he faded considerably once he knew that he'd hit him the best shots, and Berbick was still on his feet and coming for more. That coming for more really hurts. It's bad enough not to be able to hurt a guy, but when the guy comes right back at you and back at you and back at you, and pretty soon when you look across the ring and the bell hasn't sounded and the other guy is off his corner and raring to go, that's very discouraging.
Your friend Mr. Ungerman from Toronto did one heck of a job.
A wonderful
psyching him.
A wonderful success for Ungerman. Let me tell you, Ungerman is a very, very, very wonderful character boxing. He's an asset in the corner because he's so optimistic and he's so exciting. Here comes Roberto Duran.
I was just going to say, we've had all this excitement and we haven't yet hit Leonard and Duran.
I don't know if I can stand this much excitement because here comes Roberto Duran, and this place is beginning to sound like the Ali Frazier audience in Madison Square Garden in 1974. And here he comes, hands of stone, the idol of Panama and all of South America and of all the Hispanics in North and South America, Roberto Duran.
Listen to this crowd. El momento de la verdad.
The first man in the ring, Ray Arcel. Luis Enrique. There is Duran.
Roberto Duran.
What an ovation.
Listen to this crowd. Unreal. This is history.
The drums are beating and the flags are waving. Can you hear the drums? It's like a heartbeat coming up. The flags are waving and Roberto is ready for business.
Roberto Duran, considered for many years the Panamanian flag. Pound for pound, the best fighter in the world. And tonight, Sugar Ray Leonard, the man they say is going to be the greatest. We will see. Ray Arcel is trying to calm down. Mr. Arcel is a very young 82.
He just got out and threw some of the best combinations I've seen all night.
Here comes Leonard.
Roberto is cooking. They just unfurled the Canadian flag.
The referee, by the way, in this fight is Carlos Padilla. You remember him. He is... Hey, there's Leonard coming in with his entourage. Padilla is from the Philippines. It was he who worked the thriller in Manila. The judges will be Harry Gibbs, the Englishman, Angelo Poletti from Italy, and Raymond. And this one, I want to give you correctly. Valderu. Raymond Valderu. Let's get a sense of the crowd. The eyes of Duran.
And here comes the fellow Panamanian, the great ex-champion, Ismael Laguna, who's shaking with Roberto Duran. Roberto comes to our corner. He looks down.
Laguna, whom you see, beat Carlos Ortiz for the lightweight championship of the world and is considered one of the great lightweights of all time. It's a big night for Panama.
It's an excellent night for Panama. They've had great champions, but maybe none greater than Roberto Duran.
We've had one of the great surprises in years. An unknown, Trevor Berbick from Jamaica, now making his home in Canada, has knocked out John Tate. And that is the prelude to this. Sugar Ray Leonard against Roberto Duran for the World's Boxing Council's version of the Welterweight Championship. Look at this crowd, over 50,000 people, and you out there, 1,500,000 of you, the largest crowd ever in closed circuit history, and 200,000 home.
Freddie Brown has just put in about a ton of
opponent out in the first round. Also remember, the only two times he's ever been knocked down, he was knocked down on the first round. There's the Sugar.
Sugar Ray Leonard, the welterweight champion of the world, with his belt. Angelo Dundee, the very, very famous trainer, in his corner.
Let's hear Claude Mouton. That Leonard, real sweat, real warm. Duran, no, is not in a sweat.
Yeah. But he's, you see, Leonard's got, Angelo puts Abilene grease. That's the grease that makes you sweat and gets you hot. And Duran doesn't have any grease on him at all.
The referee, Carlos Padilla, giving them their last minute instructions. I got to tell you something. The Spanish has it. El momento de la verdad.
And that it is, the moment of truth.
Remember now, the referee is Carlos Padilla, and those of you who saw him work the Antifermo Minter fight may remember he does not allow fighters to hold on the inside. That was a complaint by the Duran people. They thought he might keep him from going inside, but not off of that. The moment is here. Roberto Duran challenging Sugar Ray Leonard.
Last minute instructions from Angelo Dundee. Last minute instructions from Ray Arcel.
We're ready.
And round one of the long awaited Sugar Ray Leonard, Roberto Duran, welterweight championship fight.
Ferdy, Leonard is flat-footed. He did not come out to dance. He wants to go toe-to-toe with him. He's flat-footed.
Angelo claims that in the fourth round, he will get him or sooner.
Would you believe it is Leonard coming to Duran and Duran backing up on him? Leonard snapping that left hand, now changing his pace a little. Somebody say that Duran didn't have quick hands.
He's a boxer, he's got quick hands, but Sugar Ray's got that fast jab and a jab that he moves away from after he throws it.
Notice how Duran is keeping that right hand high. He knows that Leonard wants to get him with a hook. And Arcel told me before the fight, Dundee is not going to get it his way. He can't take him out in the first round. Thrown at right hand. Duran.
Overhand right by that missed because Roberto was leaning down at the time. You can't throw those overhand rights. You got to bring them up.
Would you believe Duran is boxing him?
Yes, Durant, but he's stalking him. He's slowly cutting that distance between them. He's faking. He's slowly cutting. You see that?
Oh, he took a hard left hook. Hit him back. Leonard wants to trade with him.
Leonard wants to trade with him, and Duran is willing to oblige. Leonard is not backing off. Leonard is not running. He wants to exchange with Duran.
How about that cooking? Faked with the right hand and got him with the left hook.
Roberto the aggressor right now. Duran the aggressor. But Leonard is biding his time. He's getting his shots in. They've been even so far.
There's a lot of bad blood between the two at the weigh-in. Leonard blew a kiss at Duran, and Duran answered with a word which I cannot repeat. Duran does not like this man. But Roberto is trying to stay cool. The fury, the intensity, you can feel it.
The intensity of Duran is incredible. But Sugar Ray is very cool, and he's punching very well, counter-punching coming in. They could catch each other.
Duran goes to the body, but he's wild. He's wild. He's wild, but his intensity is great. He did not hit Leonard.
The punches were not well landed.
Leonard goes to the body and doubles up to the head.
And Leonard is throwing leather. He is throwing bombs. Leonard is throwing everything he's got this first round. Number five.
3 seconds to go in the round. 2-1. There will be no knockout in the first round. Ferdy, I really thought, and I'm telling you now, that Leonard was going to come out and try to end it right off the bat. Everybody said Duran, but I know Arcel's plan is he wants Duran to go five tough rounds because he feels that the longer the fight goes, the more it goes for Duran. We shall see.
Now watch this action as Duran comes in. See, he is wide open coming in, but he is also punching. Now he drives him to the ropes and punches. Now watch Duran. He's completely out of balance. He's got to be a little bit cooler than that with Leonard because Leonard will catch him off balance and finish him.
Leonard fighting flat-footed like he did against Pete Ranzani. I'm amazed. I thought he'd dance with this man and try to sucker him into a left hand. Angelo says Leonard does not have to dance on him. He does not want him backing up with Duran. And Duran is willing to do his thing. He's got Duran backing up.
There's a lot of feigning going on here. They're both trying to feel each other out still in spite of that hectic first round. But the Leonard fast hands are something to see.
So are Duran's.
Duran is charging in like the charge of the Life Brigade. He's almost throwing caution to the wind. You see that charge? It's intensity, it's fierceness, it's fighting. Duran is throwing caution to the wind. That could cost him, because Sugar Ray Leonard is cool.
Yes, he is. If you notice, though, Ferdy, he wants to catch Leonard with that right hand, and to do it, he's got to beat one of the greatest left hands in the business.
Duran is now closing the distance.
Boy, I tell you, I was going to say they're going to try to establish that, but son of a gun.
Look how close Duran is getting. They started out way apart.
Good job by Duran.
Here. He has not been able to get him off. He's chasing him to the ropes. Duran with two shots. Three. He's got him in the ropes again. Padilla very ineffective. He cannot break him when he wants to.
Padilla.
All right. 53 seconds to go.
You can see the clock, right. Padilla has been criticized so much about breaking guys, he doesn't want to break.
He can't break. Leonard's holding on too hard.
Yes. Leonard in trouble in round number two.
Someone just threw a cushion in, full of water, and hit both of them.
Leonard now winding up and banging with both hands. But Duran getting under them. Oh, the right hand hurt Leonard again. Leonard fighting back.
A wonderful display of courage by Leonard.
What a fight.
It's down to 7 seconds. Six. Five. And Duran has established himself.
The round is over.
Here you are. Here you go. Watch, man.
Watch.
Left hook got him in trouble. Now watch his legs. Leonard's legs buckled. He could not control himself. And now watch as he holds Duran. Now watch this other shot. A missed left hand by Leonard. Roberto measuring him. A left hook, a right hand flushes, and a left hook right on the button. And Angelo looks worried.
Ferdy, did they make a mistake?
They only made one mistake. They signed this fight. Roberto Duran is getting instructions from the corner. Angelo has got Leonard ready to go out and fight this third round.
That's probably the hardest punch he's ever been hit with as a professional. He might have been hit close to that by Bruce Curry. Round number three, Duran. Leonard still stays flat-footed with him.
Leonard is reacting to every little feint. Every little feint of Duran's is causing him to flinch. He's a little gun-shy now.
He is.
And
yes,
now's the time for Duran to take advantage of that.
He is gun-shy. Absolutely. At this moment, Duran has him compelled, but he still has those quick hands.
And I think he's got him intimidated.
Unbelievable. Oh, Duran working on him again.
Duran working on that body, and that's going to cost Ray. Because if Ray doesn't get out of there, he's going to get his ribs broken. He's punching with the intensity that only Roberto Duran can punch with.
Why would they want Leonard to take him inside?
Leonard in trouble again. His knee just buckled at that right hand. But he's coming back fighting. Now this is stupid of Leonard to get stuck on the ropes with Duran belaboring him. There he's got him again.
Duran ran into a right hand that was a little high. You know that Leonard is pulling an Ali?
Yes, but only Ali has been able to pull an Ali. What he's taking is some body shots that are going to kill him later on.
Duran getting under Leonard's shots. It's been an incredible third round, an incredible second, an incredible first. They said, could it live up to the advanced billing? Leonard might have hurt Duran a little bit. Look at Duran!
Duran is landing 10 punches to every one for Leonard. Unless Leonard can catch him off these ropes, I don't know how he can hope to win this fight this way.
Would you believe Leonard trying to match Macho with Macho?
Yeah, he's been reading the papers. That's too bad. He should have been fighting from outside. Movement is what he needs. Movement. Leonard coming on good with a combination, but it didn't seem to hurt Roberto. Roberto right above us.
Leonard with a furious assault to the body.
Leonard throwing everything he's got into the punches. Roberto ducking under him and keeps punching, keeps coming.
Angelo thinks Roberto is vulnerable in the body.
Let me tell you right now, Leonard's throwing hard.
What a round. End of the third round. You're looking at Roberto Duran and Arcel exhorting them. I just turned around to look at Wilfredo Benitez. Wilfredo? What do you think?
Duran not going away. I will be knocking him out in two rounds, you know, because in my best condition, nobody can beat me.
What do you think about this
fight? Who do you think is winning right now? ¿Quién gana ahora?
So I see the fight, so Duran.
Say it again. We had to get away for a moment. Who do you think is winning right now, Wilfredo?
It's even the fight.
Even fight. Gracias.
I don't see it that way at all. That was Wilfredo. I don't see it that way at all. That was Wilfredo Benitez, a former welterweight champion, but I have Duran ahead at this point.
I wonder if Duran is surprised, Ferdy, at the fact that Leonard is not running on him. Now Leonard is starting to use the left hand.
Leonard must move. He must move and do what got him here. He got here by being a beautiful boxer with a great jab. For him to stay on the ropes and take all that body punishment is unnecessary.
I don't know what they're trying to prove image-wise with Leonard.
I don't know if they...
He is reacting to every feint with the left hand.
He is definitely very gun-shy. Roberto is standing right in front of him. He is not catching any jabs. There's too much distance between them right now.
What surprises me is that Leonard is standing right in front of Duran. I thought he'd fight him side to side. But Leonard apparently feels he can beat him that way and beat him at his game. That's what he wants to prove.
Well, he hasn't beaten him so far. Unless they're waiting. Oh, he just got hit on. Leonard just got hit on the break. Not hard. But it goes to show you that Roberto...
Oh, a right hand! He hurt Leonard!
A tremendous right hand by Duran drove Leonard back into the ropes. And now he is holding on.
Ferdy, I just don't believe this. I cannot believe that Leonard would come out and fight as if he were fighting Pete Ranzani.
I don't think that Duran has given them any choice. He's fighting the fight that Duran is commanding right now. The difference in this fight is that Duran is fighting his fight, and Sugar Ray Leonard is not. He is being forced to fight Duran's fight, which is what you're seeing right now.
There were some who thought that a cold night would be bad for Duran. I said that he didn't have a real sweat. He's got one now as he punched himself out.
Duran will never punch himself out.
He hurt Leonard with that left hook. I would never have believed that they go to the pit this way.
I would never have believed it of Ray, because what he's doing is getting his ribs caved in. And that's going to tell later on in the fight. Ray is hoping to catch him off those ropes, and unless he does, he's in trouble.
Oh, look at Duran with that right hand. And look at Leonard
You can't see better fighting than this.
I was going to say, if you wanted to write a script, you could not have written it. Because, I mean, let's face it. You figure a young man like Sugar Ray Leonard's going to come out, stick him, suck him into the left hook. Instead, he's going out there. He's going to beat Duran at Duran's own kind of fight. We'll see whether it costs him.
Now watch this right hand. Watch Duran's right hand land flush on the chin, and watch the way that Sugar Ray has to back up into the ropes to avoid. Look at the way that Duran follows him in. That's killer instinct. These rounds are beginning to get even because Sugar is starting to fight off the ropes, and Duran is beginning to slow up at the end of the round. They cannot keep up this pace for 15 rounds.
You know, Bertie, remember I said to you, Ray, I said, oh, a left hook, he might have hurt. That was the suck punch. Bring him in and hit him with a hook.
That's because Duran has opened this round asleep. He did not open it with his intensity, and he got hit. If he lays down and tries to box with Sugar Ray Leonard, he is going to get that all night long because Leonard's hand speed is awesome.
Ray Arcel said we'll tell by round number 7 whether they've got second wind. Duran now is fighting the way he did in 71 when they called him Rocky after Rocky Graziano, going with a right hand. Or Marciano, as Freddie Brown says. And Ray Arcel says of Jack Dempsey.
Let me say that Sugar Ray Leonard has shown more guts and more gumption in these first 4 rounds than was expected of him. The champion has been fighting his heart out, but Duran has been calling the shots.
You notice that Leonard is now trying to use his size on him, bullying him, yes, leaning on him. Right hand just a little high by Duran.
But it was murder in that right hand.
Putting the pressure on Ray.
A lot of infighting here that doesn't look like much, but they're landing very short, chopping, and hard punches, both of them. Sugar Ray Leonard is really doing a job with his head.
He's also pounding to Duran's body. They believe they can get Duran, and Duran is answering back. Look at Ray go to the body. Did he hurt Duran, Ferdy?
No, those were to the side. Those were picture punches, but not hurt. Those are the ones that hurt. The one where you dig in and your feet come off the canvas with each one.
An incredible 5 rounds with Sugar Ray Leonard not doing what they thought he would do.
Oh, no.
What an incredible fight.
They have been exchanging evenly. Now watch this replay, ladies and gentlemen, as you see two fighters evenly matched. Watch Sugar Ray come out with everything he's got, but Duran is ducking all that ring experience. All of that ring experience. Now watch this. Watch this exchange between Leonard and Duran. As they get in close, they're beginning to really pummel each other. It's beginning to be tough. What Sugar Ray Leonard put on him at the end of that round should have dropped Duran, but it didn't. And now's where we get to find out how Leonard reacts to finding out that his punch is not going to knock out Duran. We know what Duran is thinking.
You know, there was a discussion at the meeting about the use of smelling salts. And originally, the Boxing Commission, the Montreal Boxing Commission, said no smelling salts. But both corners said we want to use them. You know why? Round number 6, Leonard and Duran.
Leonard has shown a lot of class in these first 5 rounds. Roberto has shown his animal intensity, and it has been a barn burner, and it is a pretty even fight. Oh, beautiful shot by Leonard, and caught Duran just like he did opening the other round. Hello. And, of course, the usual laugh from Duran.
He's starting to suck him into that left hook again. Step forward with the left foot, draw back, and bang. Incredible fight. Not what we expected at all. I figured it'd be a dancing Leonard, but he wants to beat Duran at Duran's kind of fight.
Beautiful body shot by Leonard, answered by a beautiful body shot by Duran. And back on the rope. It seems that Duran is very satisfied to back him to the ropes and wail away at the body. Leonard should not be caught there.
He feinted him twice, once with the left, then with the right, and tried to go with the left. Leonard now is not blinking or stepping away from the feints.
Leonard is in those close exchanges. Leonard's landing some short punches. There they are. Two, three, four combinations. But Roberto hangs. There it is again.
And hand speed.
Amazing hand speed by the champion, Sugar Ray Leonard, but Duran hangs in there.
Leonard bearing his attack. Body and then head. We thought that it would be Leonard holding on. That time it was Duran. Duran now trying to go underneath that left hand with a right uppercut to the body. But I must tell you, this has been a good round for Leonard.
The referee keeps knocking down Duran. Oh, that was a great shot by Leonard. The referee tries to knock out Roberto's right hand, but never. Beautiful, beautiful punch by Duran in counter punch as he came in.
Right up.
And now a hook by Leonard. How can these two guys take it?
Unbelievable.
Duran measuring him for the right hand. And just when he goes to throw it, Leonard with that superb instinct moves back. What a fighter Sugar Ray Leonard is.
Left hand, not as good as it seemed. Duran was moving back with both.
And the bell.
There's the bell. Didn't even hear it. Ernie, we'll talk with you about how you've scored it so far. I notice you're keeping a score. I haven't been. How do you score it so far?
So far, I have it just about even with Duran ahead by about a point.
58-50.
But it is so hard to score. And remember, we have judges here that are love to see fine boxing. We have not seen any fine boxing in the European style. We have seen down in the trenches fighting.
Everybody said, can he go to the pit with Duran?
He is in the pits and he's doing fine. I tell you one thing, it is an even fight, and it's so subjective that either judge can have one or the other.
Ray standing, waiting to go after him, Duran.
Let's see if he hits him that hook again to begin with. No, this time Duran puts in a hard right hand to the body.
Roberto Duran.
Steam is coming off of both fighters. They're in the middle of the ring. They have plenty of distance between them. Duran has not yet forced him to the ropes to fight his fight.
He beat Duran to the punch a little bit. Duran just missed with a right hand. Duran, by the way, was 29 years old, June 16th. Leonard is 24. Leonard, the taller of the two. I haven't identified them because I don't think you need identification. Two of the best-known fighters in the world. Again, Duran fainting with that right hand, looking to throw the left, but the right hand is his punch. Arcel and Freddie Brown up on the top step. Leonard has Duran in a bit of trouble.
Leonard fighting very well off the ropes now. Not like he was doing before.
They exchange very hard punches back into the ropes as Duran is always relentlessly pushing him back into the ropes. Leonard fighting off the ropes, trying to spin out, trying to get distance. Roberto now back to the ropes. And for the first time, we see Roberto Duran on the ropes. And for the first time, I see a little anguish on the face of Roberto Duran.
Punches to the body. The corner for Duran is yelling, get off the ropes, go to the center of the ring.
This is a very brutal physical fight. Very brutal. Ray pushes off the referee and saying, let me get to him. Let me get in this action. Back to the ropes again. Fighting off the ropes comes Ray Leonard. Fighting back comes Duran. And they're back on the ropes.
Leonard hasn't lost his hand speed. Duran seems to have lost a little of his. But now he opens up.
Every time Leonard lands a great punch, Duran comes back with three or four. Where does this man get the energy? Oh, a beautiful hook by Duran right on the button. A beautiful hook by Duran right on the button. What in the world keeps Sugar Ray up when he gets hit like that?
The same kind of guts the other man had.
Oh, boy, are they giving it to him.
He keeps showing him the right hand and trying to hit him with the left. Duran turned his back on him.
What punches? Low punches by Duran. But it doesn't seem to affect Sugar. This is Sugar Ray. This is Sugar Ray at his best. And yet he doesn't take advantage of it.
You know, Ferdy, they call him Sugar Ray Leonard. And Sugar Ray Robinson, I told you once before, George Costner touched his gloves and said, there's only one Sugar Ray, and you're not going to go more than one round. And he didn't. But he has said about this young man, Sugar Ray Leonard, he has the capacity, and he's fighting a Robinson kind of fight tonight.
Well, this fight is a seesaw battle. Just when one man looks to be getting the opportunity, the other one comes out. And one of the big surprises of this fight to me is that Sugar Ray Leonard has been able to take the terrific punishment by Duran and still be fresh and still be coming. What a fighter Sugar Ray Leonard is.
Eighth round. I'll tell you, they have respect for one another.
If they don't have it, they're getting it now. Because they have done everything they could to each other, and they're still there. Out in the middle of the ring now, a little slow beginning. That's not good for Roberto. He's going to get hit from the outside. But it's great for Sugar Ray. That's Sugar Ray's fight.
I have a feeling Roberto is trying to draw him into the right hand now.
This is the first time I have seen Padilla so active in trying to break fighters up that are fighting. Oh, a fantastic right uppercut by Leonard. Another right uppercut by Leonard right on the button. But Duran is there, and here he comes.
Look at him. Look at him doing a little dance. Now Leonard answers. But there has been no showboating in this fight by either man. They came to fight. Leonard flat-footed.
Leonard has to fight this kind of fight. Now's the time for him to open up with this kind of fight. Roberto seems momentarily flustered. He's laughing at him. He's laughing at him, but here comes Sugar Ray. Roberto taking his first break.
This is about the time he catches his second breath. Usually he got hurt with a left, but then he answered with a length of the body.
It was a tremendous jab that Sugar put in, the kind that he should have been doing all along, but he has not. He has neglected his jab, and I don't know why.
I thought Duran wanted to keep Leonard in front of him all the time, and it's Duran who's trying to come from the side. Step to one side or the other and bang with either hand. Leonard right in front of him all the time. No blink, no reaction to feints. Just the great hand speed. Been a terrific fight. Better than I thought it was going to be. I thought it was going to be great.
This is, if you can call this round slow, this is the first slow round we've had. If you can call this action slow.
There goes Duran with a nice right hand that just missed. Here comes Leonard with hand speed. Duran's got him in a corner. Duran, he's trying to get out. Oh, a great shot from Duran. Another great shot from Leonard catches Duran. And a right hand. A great right hand. How does Leonard stand it? A great right hand by Duran.
I want to ask you one question. After I catch my breath. Ferdy, is it possible? We all know that lightweights never beat welterweights for championships except once. Don't say twice, once. Because Barney Ross beat McLaren, but when Armstrong won it, he was a featherweight. Does Duran not punch as hard as a welterweight as he did as a lightweight?
He seems to be pushing pretty hard right now, not as hard as a lightweight. Watch Duran's right hand now as it lands. There's a left. Look at that right hand flush, and back comes. Back comes Leonard, and what he does. Now watch another shot of this. Look at the right hand land flush, right on the jaw. Now, if he'd have landed that on a lightweight, he'd have killed the lightweight.
Do you... You know, of course, they always questioned Leonard's chin. You think they do now?
Not indeed. Not indeed. Not his chin, not his heart, not his head, and not his fighting ability. Sugar Ray Leonard is a sensational champion, but he's got his hands full with Roberto Duran, who has given him all he wants and is on top of him every minute.
Duran now is the aggressor. He's not trying to cut him off. He doesn't have to. Leonard is right there in front of him, fighting him flat-footed.
Leonard has not danced. He has not shuffled. He has been in the trenches with him.
Duran uses that feint with the right hand, draws it back and throws the left hook. Did he cut Leonard?
No.
Leonard went to his eye. Did he cut him?
No. He put his head in there pretty good. Angelo screaming from the corner. Watch his head. Padilla's got a big lot of trouble to separate these two. Again, Duran off first. Leonard trying to fight off the ropes. He missed with a wild swinging hook and had to pay for it with a bumping body shot by Duran. Duran in a corner again. Again, Duran fighting.
He's really pressured him a lot this round, and he hasn't given him a chance to get started. It's Leonard now that goes to the center of the ring.
Duran charging with the jab. Turns it into a hook. Lands it. Now goes with both hands to the body. And Leonard has not done anything this round. Again, backing him up. Now more punches to the body by Duran. There's the ubiquitous referee in between. I don't know what Padilla's doing here. Padilla's interfering far too much in this fight. These two guys are fighting. They don't need a referee. There he goes again. They aren't even at the corner, and he's there. No rest.
Leonard tried to spin him that time and couldn't do it. They are two master craftsmen. Superb fighters.
Duran is winning this round unless Leonard can turn it around at the end here. This round has been all Duran. You cannot give Duran that kind of edge. Every round is going to be important from now on.
Leonard's got to go to the uppercut if he expects to do anything, because Duran is coming in under those wide punches, as you pointed out, just coming under him.
He has a great ability to bend under punches. Leonard has stopped fighting this round, and I don't know why, unless he's taking a breather.
Catching a second breath, maybe.
It's not like Angelo to tell his fight.
Good right hand! Oh, they both do! Duran is on top of him again, and Leonard won't quit either. The round is is almost over. Ray Arcel has the back. What a fight.
I must say that there is no way that this man can retain his championship if he has another round like that. That round was all Duran fighting and Sugar Ray. Now there's something going on in his corner. They're pressing against his eye as if he has a cut or something is bothering Leonard's eye.
That's what I mentioned to you before.
And
look.
Yeah. Angelo, the great cut man, is putting adrenaline in. Now, Angelo's got some adrenaline. He is applying adrenaline to the eye of Sugar Ray Leonard, which means that Sugar Ray Leonard is cut right at the eyebrow of the right eye. It must not be big. I didn't see blood, but Sugar Ray talking. And Angelo has put the adrenaline and the cut stuff in. Another factor in this fight, Sugar
Ray. Number 10.
Number 10 coming up. Many people picked this. It's the round that Duran would knock out Sugar Ray Leonard. Good right hand by Duran.
Leonard has not lost his cool, and neither fighter really has taken what you would call command of the fight. But Leonard now starting to get up a little more on his toes and go to the left hand. A little more on the toes, go to the left hand. Duran now sweeping at him, maybe feeling more confident.
Duran should have felt very confident after that last round.
You're right. Oh, he hurt Duran with the left hook. No, he didn't.
Duran smiles. Duran just cannot be beaten or intimidated by this man. He got hit a hard hook. He laughed and kept on coming.
Ray is starting to blink again. He's starting to blink again.
And Ray is beginning to look worried when Duran comes in. The first time I've seen that expression on Leonard's face. A good left and a right by Duran. Duran just looked over here and smiled at me. I can't believe that guy's got that presence of mind. Duran looked in our direction, smiled at me as if to say, how do you like this? He does not seem to be able to respect the punching power of Sugar Ray Leonard.
That's where he needed the uppercut, either left or right, and all he's doing is hooking.
And punching down on a guy who's turning down. A thumping good hook to the body by Leonard. Duran has abandoned what's got him here this far. Uh-oh. He's playing games with him. He's
training
him. Oh, what a shot by Duran to the body of Leonard. Leonard came back with two ineffective punches to the body. Duran chasing him back to the ropes, which is where he wants to be. There he is, back to where he likes to be. Home territory. Home cooking on the ropes for Duran.
Leonard now coming after him, but let's face it, two great fighters. What can you say? They're both. They talk about Duran being an animal. I want to tell you, Sugar Ray is great.
Exchanges. What exchanges by Leonard?
Yes.
Leonard going toe-to-toe with Duran and getting the best of that exchange. But Duran always relentless and back and the aggressor and pushing and pulling. Leonard got off the three best punches of the round.
Ferdy, you've been around Angelo how many years?
20 years.
Did you think that he was going to send Leonard out to fight this man's fight?
I did not. This is the biggest surprise. Outside of Tate getting knocked out, this is the biggest surprise that Angelo has got this guy fighting in the trenches with Duran. Because obviously, Duran is in home territory when he's on the ropes and flat-footed and wailing away. He's shorter. That means his face is getting into, his head is getting into Leonard's face. He's cutting him. He's confusing him. He's frustrating him. And now he's even beating him to the punch in the middle of the ring. Now, Leonard looks very tired at this moment. He looks a little weary, a little discouraged. He's now got to come on. Angelo's giving him that pep talk that he gives him. We're behind. We need this round.
And Arcella's doing the same with Duran. Round number 11. Round number 11.
They've met at the middle and exchanged punches. Neither one effective.
Neither one. Duran doesn't look tired at all, and Leonard is punching like he isn't.
He got hit very low. Leonard just got hit very low just then.
That isn't the first time a Duran fight has seen that. He holds no part of the man's body, sack or sack. He's a pit fighter.
He's just throwing punches wherever they have. Good right hand landed on Duran. A good right hand landed, and now they're both exchanging furious volleys. As fast as Leonard goes, Duran comes back.
Right back. Right back.
No advantage to either one.
I was about to say that some of the sting may have gotten out of Duran, but you can't tell. Hard to tell. Short punches now by Leonard, trying to take him with the right hand. I tell you, he's caught his breath. Leonard, so far this round, has used greater hand speed.
And Duran has been punching without the authority that he had in the other rounds. He slowed down.
Oh, Leonard, beating a tattoo. But Duran stays on top of him and hurts him.
He has just hurt Leonard, and Leonard comes back again. It's just that Duran won't quit. He just keeps going and going and going.
Look at Leonard fight back. And Duran. Unbelievable vision of this crowd.
Look at the way they're going, one after the other. Duran actually keeps pinning him back to the ropes, and that's his fight. Leonard can't seem to... Oh, Leonard threw everything he had in a punch and almost turned himself around. They're both extremely tired. I've never seen Duran lose punching power like now.
Leonard punched himself out. Duran is starting to come back at him.
I've never seen Duran punch so slowly, but he's been punching so hard. They're both exhausted.
We're in the 11th round. Four more to go. Arcel was right. He said, we'll see who goes 15.
That's what this is going to be, who goes 15.
Leonard coming back with a flurry of Duran answers. And hit him right by Cook.
They're just exchanging those volleys. It's incredible to me that one can come back to the other. Leonard may have evened it up now, but I still have Duran slightly ahead. He may have evened it up. He was just starting to look good. And for the first time, Duran is beginning to look weary in his punching power. I have never seen Duran run out of steam when it comes to punching.
The officials tonight, only the judges vote. The referee, Carlos Padilla, has no vote. No vote. Harry Gibbs, Angelo Paletti, and Raymond Baldireux. Now, Baldireux presumably has no reaction one way or the other to Styles. Gibbs likes boxing. Paletti likes aggressiveness. We're in round number 12.
I don't think they've seen much boxing, but they've seen a lot of aggressiveness.
By both.
Both fighters have been supreme fighters. Good right hand by Duran to begin this round. Exchanging jabs in the middle, not hurting each other, but not starting off fast. Duran doesn't seem to show any inclination to close right now, being satisfied to stay away for a few seconds. How can you blame them? They've been going toe-to-toe.
Freddie, who's the stronger man of the two physically, do you think?
Right now, you really can't tell. Right now, they're both pretty exhausted.
Sugar Ray Leonard has taken to the body should have caved in a heavyweight.
This is a replay of Robinson LaMotta. Hanging to the body.
Roberto is much busier. Roberto is much busier than Sugar Ray Leonard. That was a string. The string was hanging from Roberto Duran's glove, and Padilla took it up. Rightly so.
Stop the clock, too. He showed him the right hand again and going at him with the left and hit him with a good hook. Duran did.
Duran seems to be getting his second win here.
Duran showing him the right hand and using the left. Oh!
But that's a mistake because Duran is a mongoose. He comes back. What a thunderous punch Sugar Ray Leonard landed, but Duran is still there. What in the world has Duran got for a heart?
Unbelievable.
Good right hand by Duran. Just when Sugar Ray Leonard was going to get on track, he got hit by a right hand.
I don't think he's got the sting he had earlier.
I don't think either one of them have the sting better. Sugar Ray just took a deep breath, which is a sign of weariness.
It has been the plan, obviously, to go to Duran's body. Duran short with the right hand and does not look to be snapping it the way he did earlier. But you can't tell. I never can tell with Roberto. Leonard now hit him a little bit low. And the bell. 12th round.
Now we'll see a replay and you will see the kind of punch. Look at that shot land. Now comes back with another shot. Look at this shot land. I am telling you, these people are throwing the kind of leather that would knock anybody out. They missed on the last two punches, but they had landed solid the two punches before. What's keeping both of them up? I do not know, folks.
Ferdy, I have to remind everyone, a draw, the champion remains the champion. Please remember that. In the event of a draw, Leonard would retain his crown. I mention that because it is that close a fight.
I want to tell you, in the event of a draw, meet me under the ring because there's going to be a lot of debris flying if this fight's a draw.
Leonard standing. That's what Eder Joffre used to do, the great Brazilian. He always stood. Round number 13.
Round 13, and I believe that Roberto senses that he's got the fight if he keeps up the pressure. I do not believe that Sugar Ray thinks he's losing this fight. It's very possible both corners think they're ahead. It's that close. This is in the hands of the judges unless one of two, one of each.
Oh, a left hook
by Duran! Unless these fighters take the solution in their own hands, this is going to be a hard fight to judge.
Duran a little more aggressive in this round than Leonard.
Well, I believe he's been aggressive through the whole fight. Pushing Leonard to the ropes, mauling him, keeping him there. You have to give him points for aggressiveness, but Sugar Ray's fought brilliantly off the ropes at times.
They're both trying to fake one another into a lead because they want to counter off the lead. Duran surprised, I am sure, at the body attack. I don't think he's ever gone through one like that. A left hook should have hurt Leonard. It didn't. It did not.
Leonard had just landed his superb punch and got hit by a hook. He's retreating back to the corner. Duran's favorite hunting ground. That corner over there has been the pitfall for Sugar Ray Leonard. They seem to gravitate to that as if pulled by some kind of invisible magnet. And when he's there, it's all Duran.
Party, you were in Manila, I was not. Is this like the thrill in Manila?
This is the thrill in Canada, in Montreal. This is just like the thrill in Manila.
Oh, right hand! A right hand by Duran! And a right hand by Leonard!
What a sensation! And one fighter land one thing, then the other lands exactly the same. Now Leonard coming on with a combination of three different punches that landed.
We did it in chorus.
Right above us, Roberto Duran and Sugar Ray exchanging furious punches. Here comes Duran. Leonard taking the punches, has to back up. And now Leonard trying to come back. But he takes the punishment as he's coming up. Now Leonard trying to bend Duran to the ropes. They're exchanging punches. Again, they're exchanging. And neither man has been hurt. Right now, Sugar Ray has landed devastating body blows, but Duran is still in front of him. Duran punching away. Leonard taking everything.
They're yelling, move away, Leonard, but he won't. He will. Oh, he's been hurt on the front, but he comes back. He's hurt away.
Duran is hurt. Duran is hurt. Wow. Oh, what a fight. Duran is hurt. What a fight at the bell. Duran was hurt for the first time. He clutched.
You know, the image of Ray in America, Leonard, the face of a poet.
He's got a heart as big as Duran, and he also has fists of granite.
Look at this exchange.
Right hand on the button, left hand on the button, and now another right on the back of the head, which does not make you feel good, folks. And now they bounce back, another right hand. At the bell. Now that should have encouraged Sugar Ray Leonard. Angelo Dundee, the great corner man, patting him in the back. We need this, baby. Go get it. Go get it.
Look at Duran yelling, I'll be there. I'll be there. He came out with a right hand lead that just missed the chin of Duran.
And Duran came back with a thumping body shot. Hello, here we are again, he said. That's not enough to intimidate Roberto Duran. It's round 14. And if he's going to change it, save his championship, Sugar Ray Leonard must fight. Oh, a great by Leonard. Now Sugar Ray is fighting an inspired fight. He seems to sense that he needs this. He's trading with him.
I can't believe it. I cannot believe that Leonard would fight this kind of fight. He's not only made a believer, he's doing a hell of a job at it. Leonard has come out smoking and Duran waiting a little bit, but he'll be there. They both will. I don't want to pick this one. Leonard's getting to him a little bit more with that left hook now. Duran, though, comes right.
Oh, what a hook, left hook. What a hook by Duran. Duran dug a body shot, came back with a left hook. And a straight right hand to Duran. Now they're back, toe-to-toe.
30.
It seems, uh-oh.
Did he hurt Leonard?
Leonard just shook his head in one of those exhausted motions that fighters make. What fucking exchanges. Even exchanges.
What a great fight.
Leonard seems to sense that he needs this to keep his title.
Yeah,
he needs
the
these last
feeling.
Two rounds, and he does. Bill, he needs these last two rounds.
What is that? You mentioned in the tape fight, digging him with your toes to the canvas. That's what they're doing. In boxing terms, they call this a war. 24 seconds remaining in the 14th round.
Leonard, see another view of this. Here comes. There he goes. He winds it up once. He winds it up twice and lets it fly. When's the last time you saw that, folks? Kid Gavilan.
30. 15th round. Let's decide it.
I think this decides the fight.
I see. You got a dead even.
This decides the fight. What a sensational bout. Round 15. Who would have thought of this? This crowd is on their feet in tribute. Even ringside spectators, even the press, is up on its feet.
15th round could be the decider. It's close. I don't have to tell you that. Leonard has fought a courageous fight. Not the smartest fight, but a courageous fight. And Duran has been Roberto Duran. He's always there. It's a war.
Sugar Ray Leonard has shown every inch a champion. What a magnificent fighter Sugar Ray Leonard has shown himself to be. And no less Roberto Duran, who has pressured and pushed and mauled and sent him to the ropes time after time after time. They're back to the ropes.
Freddie, no matter who the winner is, it's going to be a rematch.
Oh, I would say so. Here they come again. Roberto looking for that right hand.
He hasn't gotten off. He has not gotten off in the 15th round. He's got to do some punching. Leonard has taken the play away from him so far.
Either the corner thinks they're so far ahead they can win this fight, or I don't know what's happening to him. Because he should be fighting like a man back right now.
Remember, Leonard has never lost a fight. Duran has only lost once. Esteban de Jesus.
1 minute and 24 seconds to go. Roberto is not pressuring him, and I do not understand why. This fight, this round could cost him the fight if he doesn't pressure him. They're both tired.
I think Leonard's got a little more gas left. He's doing all the punching. Roberto can smile,
either
but he's not punching.
Either that or Roberto is saving himself for the last minute.
Now he's starting to try to spin him around and hit him. He's making Leonard miss. But he's got a punch.
Now he's playing with him. He's playing with Sugar Ray Leonard. I don't understand why. He's showing him, here's what the defensive fighting looks like.
Arcel is yelling to him to punch. He knows that he needs it. How much time we got?
1 minute.
1 minute. Leonard doing, oh no. It's down to 26, 25 seconds. This one will go all the way. And we're going to have a decision. And then Leonard may have pulled it out with a 15th round. Leonard bombing away. And Duran
apparently feels he's won his fight and doesn't have to fight the 15th round.
There's the clock. Seven.
I can't believe it.
Six.
I can't
five,
believe it.
Four. Duran thinks he has won the fight.
I can't believe it.
The bell. It's over.
He thinks he's won this fight and didn't have to fight the 15th round.
I think he thought so. He thinks he's won.
I think he thought he won.
I think Leonard thinks he won. I mean, Duran thinks he won.
Oh, no.
See. Now he's yelling at Benitez. Can you see? He's yelling at Benitez. Shall see shortly who the winner is. I repeat what I said to you before. In case of a draw, Leonard,
they're having trouble
in the corners. Yeah, the corners are getting after one another. They've got to stop that. They've got to stop it. In case of a draw, Leonard is the winner. Remember that. Luis Enriquez is getting some of the Panamanian contingent back to the corner. I cannot even begin to give you an idea, but it looks close.
Well, what it looks like, Bill, is that Sugar's resigned to losing, and Duran knows he won the fight. Let us hope it works.
We shall see. Claude Mouton will give you the decision. Here you are. Here you are. Here you are.
Here's the decision.
Claude, come to the middle so we can see you and hear you.
Le président du Conseil Mondial de la Boxe, the president of WBC, Señor José Suleiman, le président de la Fédération Canadienne, the president of the Canadian Federation, Murray Sleep. Le président de la Commission Athlétique de Montréal, the president of the Montreal Athletic Commission, Arthur Gagnon, et le président exécutif du Conseil Mondial de la Boxe, the executive president of the World Boxing Council, Piero Pini, from Italy.
Let's have the decision. Come on. I am not sure. You can see the corner of Leonard. That's Dave Jacobs, his trainer. It's close. I cannot believe that if there's a difference, there's a point. But obviously, Duran's corner thought he was winning, because in the 15th round, they let Leonard do all of the leading. They are going to have to check the card, and we shall shortly see who the winner in this fight is. Let's see who the winner is. Obviously, Duran feels that he has won the fight, but if we look at Sugar Ray, he fought a tremendous fight. Let us hear. Come on, men. Birdie.
There's a tremendous amount of tension building in the ring. Obviously, Roberto Duran is totally confident, fully confident. One. And Leonard seems to be very dejected.
Here is the announcement.
Officiel des juges.
It appears, here's the
decision. Here is the official decision. Le juge va dire Duran 146, 146. Leonard 144, 144.
146-144 for Duran.
Duran 147-147. Leonard 147-147.
He called it a draw.
Juge gives Leonard 144. Duran 145. Le nouveau.
What was the last vote? I did not hear the last vote. Bernie Pacheco is in the ring.
And it's going to be difficult to get to him in a moment. He will be brought here as soon as they finish celebrating. So,
the excitement is set. Please get him off. 145-144. It was a split decision. I was off by a point. I thought it was a draw. Roberto Duran has won the welterweight championship of the world. Bernie Pacheco, can you hear me? Bernie.
Come on, come on, come on.
Come on, Roberto. Roberto is...
We're waiting for Ferdy Pacheco.
The champion.
We got to do you a favor, fellas.
Roberto Duran.
Roberto Duran. Luis Enriquez. Don King. The champion of the world. Roberto Duran.
Muchas gracias. Yo sabía que yo me lo ganaba. Yo soy más hombre que él. Aguanto más que él. Yo soy más boxeador que él.
Duran says he knew he would win it. He was more of a man. He was more strong. And he knew he could do it. Don King.
Oh, I'm so happy. Roberto Duran worked so hard. He's a great champion. He proved today that he is truly man of every address.
Oye, Roberto. All right. All right. Te lastimaron, Roberto. Él te lastimó.
No, él no me lastimó. Él me pegó duro, pero no me hizo daño.
He never got hurt by him.
Yo soy muy fuerte.
¿Por qué no peleaste el último round 15? Ya sabías que
la... Claro, si no me había ganado la pelea a mí. Yo sabía que él venía a noquearme, entonces yo tenía que ponerlo nervioso y ponerlo para allá.
I asked him why he didn't fight the 15th round.
Yo soy el boxeador, yo fui el que boxeé.
He said he boxed, he didn't fight the 15th round. And now he goes, congratulations, Roberto Duran, the new welterweight champion of the world in an incredible night of fighting, which saw Sugar Ray Leonard defeated in his unexpected fashion by Roberto Duran. A split decision which surprised some because they felt a unanimous decision. Bala, here comes Luis Enriquez, who has been one of the stalwarts in Duran's camp. Did you feel that he didn't fight the 15th round because he knew he had it won, Luis?
Ferdy, I would say one thing. When he came up in the 13th round, he said to Ray, I know I won. I know I won. So Ray said, but you got to fight two more rounds. He said, okay, Pops. What happened in my feeling when I move out the corner, Duran knew that within the 14th round, then the fight was sealed, and he decided to box instead of continue fighting.
He boxed very, very well.
Very well.
Did you feel that the split decision was just, or did you think it was a unanimous?
It was a unanimous decision, Ferdy. It was obvious. It was obvious.
Would you say that this magnificent fight was one of the best welterweight fights?
One of the best fights I've ever seen in my life.
And would you like a rematch?
Definitely. Anytime.
And so we leave.
This is Bill Mazur for Ferdy Pacheco, the winner, Roberto Duran. Goodbye from Montreal, Canada.
Second.
Duran. Where is he? Yes. What does he want? Does he want Pacheco? Ask him. I can't do Duran. I don't speak Spanish. How'd you like the broadcast? You know that I was 1 point off. Did I tell you it was going to be a draw? Goodbye.